Hey there! In this how-to video, we'll build a gacha box using Machinations. It's going to be a simplified version of earning and opening hextech chests in League of Legends. We picked this example because Riot makes the items drop rates public, so there was no need to guesstimate them. You can find a link to that piece of information in the description of the video if you're watching this on our YouTube channel, or below it if you're tuning in directly from our documentation page. The purpose of this exercise is to get you through most of the nodes in the Machinations framework and show you how they work. We're not in this to design a fail-proof state-of-the-art gacha, but to show you how you would go about expressing something like it in Machinations. Just a heads up, we're assuming you have gone through a bit of the documentation and you have a basic knowledge of the framework. So if you haven't done that, this would be a perfect time to do so. Pause this and we'll be waiting for you to get back. Great. Let's get started. We're in the Machinations workspace. In the panel on the left, we have the Machinations nodes. This construct we're trying to achieve is pretty complex, even in the simplified version, so I'll go through each step and explain everything I'm doing. I'll first rename my diagram and I'll cheat because I already have the name in my clipboard. Now, most Machinations diagrams start with the source. These are basic nodes in Machinations, and they create resources. The star symbol on the upper right of the source, I just drag and drop, signifies that it will be triggered automatically once I run my diagram. Resources can be anything from coins, gems, ammo, but in this example, the source will produce key fragments and chests, which is what my player needs to be able to get the rewards. Getting these rewards is dependent on playing a game, so that's how I'll name this source. Play game. I'll focus on the key fragments part first. What I need at this point is to transform a resource created by my play game source into a rate or a chance of drop for a key fragment. For this, I'll add a gate. This node, once activated, will redistribute resources without collecting them. When I first drag a gate, it's defaulted to deterministic, but to represent a drop rate, I'll need it to be probabilistic. So I'll click the dice symbol in the distribution settings right here. This gate, together with its connection, will determine the chance of my player to get a key fragment. But let's not skip steps. I'll first add a pool to collect key fragments. I did this by double-clicking on the pool node while the gate I already have on my canvas is selected. This will automatically place the pool connected to the input through a resource connection. I can now easily set the rate at which the resource will be redistributed by the gates to my pool by adding a label on the connection. Let's see how this works. I'll hit the run button here. The source starts producing resources, sends them through the gate with a 40% chance of them being distributed as a key fragment, and then we collect the outcome in the pool. By default, my pool is set to show the resources it collects as small coins. But here I want to see them as numbers. I'll stop the diagram, select the pool, and in this menu here, under Capacity, I'll set the pool to display numbers instead of symbols, starting from the very first resource it gets. I'll run the diagram again. This works, so I can continue designing the system. We need these key fragments to be forged into hextech keys, so I'll add a converter to my diagram. Converters transmute one or more resources into others. Put differently, they consume resources from the input and produce resources as an output. The rates at which this works are set by the labels on the connection. What I want is for the converter to consume three key fragments and produce one key. I'll add another pool for the keys, and then I'll set this resource connection to pull three key fragments and convert them into one key. I could put one on this resource connection here, but there's no need because it defaults to one. I also need to make the converter automatic, and I will mention it needs to wait for my player to have all three key fragments and only then pull them. So in the drop-down menu on the right-hand side, in action, I'll select Pull All. This functional menu is where you will have all the attributes of nodes and connections. I'll hit run again and wait for the player to earn three key fragments and see if they get converted. And they do. Let's move on to the chest drops. I'll first rearrange the diagram a bit to accommodate the second branch, and I'll use color to differentiate between the two resources, key fragments and chests. Though Machinations supports functional color coding, what I'm doing here is just for aesthetics. Functional color coding will have its own how-to video. But let's go back to the diagram at hand. Using the same reasoning, I'll transform a play game resource into a drop rate via a gate. For you to earn a chest in League of Legends after playing a game, you or one of your teammates need to get an S rank. For those of you who haven't played League of Legends, you get ranked for each game you play based on how you played with the champion you chose, S-, S, and S+, being the highest grades you can get. But getting the rank alone does not automatically grant you a chest. More conditions need to be met. So, I'll add another gate to account for these odds and the pool to collect the chests you'll eventually get. You may have noticed I haven't yet set the probabilities for the gates. We need some more background for that. Getting the S rank depends on a lot, like you playing at your best, the configuration of your team. That's a lot, so let's say 20% for all that to happen. Now, the probability of you getting a chest after getting the S rank takes into account a series of other factors regarding the champion you just played. So I'll set this gate's rate at 15%. Notice that these percentages are pretty much random and that I'm blackboxing multiple conditions. When you're designing this for your own game though, you'll have much more info to go on, either from design or actual player data. Let's test this system so far. Apparently, this may take a while. So to save on time, I'll stop the diagram and do a quick run. Look at quick run as a fast forward feature. Our player now has both hex deck chests and keys. Once both one key and one chest are available, I'll assume my player will use them, so they will be automatically pooled by a converter set to pool all. This converter represents the action of a player opening a chest, and it'll be transformed into a chance of getting an item. Here go the loot items and their drop rates. Let me first change the view to a full canvas and adjust it. I already have the item drops mapped out and saved into my library, so I'll just drag and drop them. This gate, with multiple outputs, will distribute the resources resulting from opening a chest into one of the pools here, according to their respective probability stated on the resource connections. I'll zoom out and hit run. There you have it. Your player has loot and is happy with it, or not, and has already traded it in for some essence. Anyway, that's a simple gacha mapped out with Machinations. This diagram I just built can be accessed from your Machinations account in File, New from Template. You can tweak it, change it, and when you have the system that works for your game, select all or part of it and add it to your library for easy drag and drop access. Hope this was useful. In our next video, we'll be showing you how to use color coding. If you have any questions or suggestions, post your comments below or write us at contact@machinations.io. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Till next time.